بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم. I'd be live on the phone, the religious accent.
Alhamdulillah.
Right. No, you know what, actually, so when we started today, you know, the numbers were less than last time. And I'm just going to speak, you know, how I feel really. And, you know, and the first thing I thought to myself was like, you know, the numbers are going to be less. But the truth is, and subhanAllah, the first, you know, first sentence that we recite here is Alhamdulillahi alladhi hadana. That's the first thing that we say when we start the maulid, is, you know, praise to Allah, Alhamdulillahi alladhi, the one who's guided us, who's hadana. You know what I mean? And regardless, even if it's one person here, one person, you have to say Alhamdulillah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided you or I to be in a gathering like this. You know what I mean? The gathering, you know, the gathering has the same rank with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regardless of how many people attend that gathering. Gathering has the same rank. Because why? بِعَبْدِهِ الْمُخْتَارِ, by virtue of his slave, of his servant, which is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That this gathering is by virtue of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's got nothing to do with you and I. You can get the biggest sheikh or whatever attending the gathering. Yes, the gathering has Nurun ala nur, it has blessings, you know, lights upon light. It has, you know, blessing upon blessings. But the ultimate blessing is what? It's by virtue of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And no one can, you know, they say, Huzur ki mehfil ko, Huzur se jate hain. You know what I mean? But this is the gathering of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the guest of the gathering is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And, you know, the host of the gathering is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That this gathering is by virtue of him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's got nothing to do with how many people attend, how many people come. We just said Alhamdulillah that Allah guided us to attend, because if others haven't, you know, whatever that, you know, like, you know, good opinion about it, whatever the circumstances are. But regardless of ourselves, Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed us to gathering. A zikr, a gathering, that's by virtue of him, salawatullah wa salamun alayhi. And the thing is, by virtue, what isn't by virtue of him? That we are created by virtue of him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, every prophet become a prophet by virtue of accepting his prophecy. By virtue, la tu'minunna bihi wa tansurunnahu. That you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, that la tu'minunna, that you, triple emphasis, that you will believe in him. And you will be, and you know, another tafsir of that is be he, but you will believe by virtue of him. And this is two prophets, you know what I mean? And then you will assist him, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who helps the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it's like, you know, like the time when the Sahabas were bodyguards of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, literally, you know, serving outside his house sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they will remain outside protecting the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was told that, look, you know, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I protect you. You don't really need these people to protect you. I mean, paraphrasing. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam come outside and said to Sahaba, leave, you know, I don't need you to stay here at night. And then all the Sahabas go, one Sahaba remains, you say that. And the Prophet says, come back, and I said, look, leave. And he said, I've changed my profession. I'm a servant. I've come as your slave, Ya Rasulullah. Now I've come as your servant. And the Prophet says, again, he doesn't need his service either. The Prophet says, ask, like, you come to serve me, you tell me what you want. The Prophet says, ask, and I'll give it to you now. You know, ask. And what a smart Sahaba. He says, give me 3 days, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rasulullah, give me 3 days. So he goes away and the Prophet comes back after 3 days. You know, it's amazing, like, subhanAllah, these people, you know, it's amazing. You know, they were people of, you know, haqqul yaqeen, like they were in a true sense of belief in terms of their iman, like this highest, like the shahada. And that's our shahada is a, you know, we are proclaiming our iman. That shahada was, they were witnessing. Remember, the shaheed is the one who witnesses. That's the shaheed, the one who's witnessed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You get me? And that our shahada is what we, you know, testify. You mean, we verbally testify. But they they were their shahada was what they were seeing, what they were witnessing. And they were witnessing the biggest ayah, the biggest sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he comes back to Sahaba, you know, radiallahu anhu, and he says the ultimate thing. He doesn't ask for Jannah. He doesn't ask for wealth. He doesn't ask for anything. He asked for his companionship in Jannah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, your companionship in Jannah. That's what he asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet said, you know, you can assist me, but I could give you that. You know, assist me, you know, give me something, you know, pray at the hajj, do a bit of fasting, do something though I could back you up on that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yeah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's giving out Jannah like tokens, and he's giving for those, like, yeah, how for those, how, you know, Usman for Jannah, Abu Bakr for Jannah, Umar for Jannah. This was a revelation. You're not going to read an ayah in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Kul," you know what I mean? Say, O Prophet, Usman in Jannah, Abu Bakr for Jannah. This is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, deciding for himself, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with given authority by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Abu Bakr for Jannah, Usman for Jannah, Umar for Jannah, Ali for Jannah, you're all in Jannah. And he goes on and down. How many times the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, he just sat down, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, today, you know, a man's gonna walk through that door, he's a man of Jannah. The Prophet doesn't give him Jannah out like that, like, you know, you wanna get to Jannah, do this for me. You know, do this. That's it, khalas, the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's just taking everyone with him. Salawatullah wa salam alayhi to Jannah. So, bi abdihi, you know, by virtue of him, salawatullah wa salam alayhi, and everything is by virtue of him. Like, I was speaking to someone today, and you know, the brother, you know, sincere brother and stuff, and he was saying, like, you know, we're talking about podcast shows and it's a media environment, Muslim brother, and he's saying, like, you know, you go, we try to give Islamic messages, but not with the message of, like, basically indirectly, you know, Islam. You know, giving Islamic message indirectly and not really attributing it to religion, what at the same time teaching the same principles and whatever. And I'm like, why? Like, how dare you? Like, khalas, look, all goodness that we have in life is a credit to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is a reference of it. You know, you can refer to Einstein and, you know, different philosophers and scientists, and you can refer it back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Like, every virtue we have of life traces back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Every goodness that we have of life traces back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Like, you have to give the haq. Like, don't think you're doing religion a favor by saying, "Oh, I'm just here trying to give the message, but you know, I'm trying to keep it very subtle." Why? Like, you're taking all these gifts from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you can say whatever platform, maybe a professional platform, a, you know, Western platform, a non-Muslim platform, khalas, you won't feel. If they feel awkward about it, that's their problem. Like, these are facts. And we said, we claim we want to challenge racism, we want to promote good health, we want to promote good societies. And you got to reference it back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because he is the reference. He is, you know, it goes back to him, sallallahu wasallam. He broke the archetype of virtue. And why would we not, you know, accredit or attribute to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, regardless what platform is. So anyway, you know, bi abdihi al-mukhtari man da'ana, you know, by virtue of the chosen slave, salawatullah wa salam alayhi, and he is the chosen one. And you know what I mean, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows to be chosen ones of his chosen one, salawatullah wa salam alayhi, because we just need to come unto his gaze, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once. We just need to come unto his gaze. It's one gaze of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like, you know, like in the Shama'id, you come across a Shama'id that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is described, he's described as sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he will look upon the earth more than he will look upon the heavens. Meaning, like, he will look down more than he will look up, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why was that? Because the effect of his gaze. Like, one of the things that his humility about, as well as that, it was, you know, the ulama, they say it's because the effect of his gaze, the responsibility of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the amana of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of his penetrating gaze, that if he looks upon you, khalas, you change your state. And if he looked at you long enough, like what they say, the women around Yusuf, alayhi salam, you know, would cut their hands out of the beauty of the Prophet Yusuf, but the men around the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would have ripped out their hearts if he weren't for the veils placed around him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that men couldn't see upon the gaze upon the face of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All the ahadith that narrate the description of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whether it be Hazrat Ali or Hind bin Abi Hala, these are all the people, Anas ibn Malik, all the people that narrate the description of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, are all people who are grew up with the Prophet, meaning they were around the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as children. Because there's only the children that could gaze upon the face of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You mean the Sahaba, the elder Sahaba, could gaze upon the face of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like looking at the sunlight, you know what I mean, looking at the sun, because of the majesty of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because he had a majestic character. Remember, innaka ala khuluqin azim. Azim, azama is only given to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in terms of character. No other Prophet. Like, there's many attributes you can give to prophetic character, like, you know, Haseen and Hussein and, you know, all these beautiful words that can be, they are attributed to prophetic character. But azama is only given to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as majestic. His character was majestic. And that's one of the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him, himself, Azim, one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it's also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one of his attributes, same wording, different definition, is azama, or the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, you know, alhamdulillah, that's my point, alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows to be part of this gathering. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Jazakumullah khair.